if you look for machine learning on Google Trends, you'll notice that in last few years, the trend is going up. So a lot of people are searching for this term on Google, and the popularity of machine learning has been steadily increasing. Of course, you'll see some dips, but those dips are around Christmas and New Year. And obviously, during that period, people have more important things to do. There was an interview by Steve Jobs around 1990, where he made use of a bicycle analogy. There was a study done to assess efficiency of locomotion of going from place A to place B for various species, including humans. And humans did not really do very well on that list. They were way down. In fact, even a horse performed much better than humans. But then when this study included humans with a bicycle, that was totally a game changer. In fact, man with the bicycle did exceedingly well and they were off the charts. So using this analogy of bicycle, Steve Jobs called computers as the bicycle of the mind. So we are talking about 1990 when Mac had RAM of 1 megabyte and storage was just 40 megabytes. So we have come a long way and today's computers are much faster. Probably we could say that computers are aeroplanes of mind. So computers have become very powerful, and that's one thing that has led to the growth of machine learning. In machine learning, the word machine basically refers to computer. And this learning basically is with data. And data can be classified mainly into two categories. One category is the structured data, where you have nice rows and columns that we are familiar with when we have Excel files or CSV files. And the second category is unstructured data, which includes text like tweets or customer comments on Amazon and so on. Or it could be images, pictures, or videos. So those are unstructured data. Now, learning itself can be classified into two major categories. One is supervised learning and other is unsupervised learning. So in supervised learning, our data has a response variable and the machines are fed with that training data and they are trained to learn few things. In fact, nowadays we have a lot of gadgets that have learned to answer some of the questions. For example, let's ask Siri a question. Hey Siri, what is machine learning?
Machine learning is a field of computer science that uses statistical techniques to give computer systems the ability to learn with data without being explicitly programmed. The name machine learning was coined in 1959 by Arthur Samuel.
So you can see these gadgets are now trained and they have learned few things and they can answer some simple questions. But obviously they have some limitations. This is like artificial intelligence and not real intelligence. If I ask same question slightly differently, let's see what happens. Can you throw some light on machine learning?
I can't get the answer to that on HomePod.
So basically what I want to show is that machine learning has some limitations. They cannot like 100% imitate real intelligence. And there are several popular machine learning models. For example, you might have heard of linear regression. And then there is logistic regression, decision trees, naive Bayes, of course, neural networks, support vector machines, random forest, and so on. In fact, within machine learning, when big neural networks are used, so that field is called deep learning. Some other examples that we commonly see in daily life include face recognition on iPhone X or face recognition used by Facebook or Google for sorting pictures and images. And then when you look at unsupervised learning, so there are several methods that are very popular. For example, when you watch a movie or a TV show or a documentary on Netflix, so Netflix will recommend to you what you should watch next. That's based on recommender systems. Similarly, if you search for something on Amazon.com, it will suggest to you that those people who looked for item A also found item B useful. Another popular unsupervised learning method is clustering. So clustering algorithm basically looks for how close or far each item is when measured across different features. Now coming to jobs in this field, if you go on LinkedIn and search the term machine learning, at this point in time, we see that there are more than 30,000 openings available just in US. And there are different levels of these jobs. If you are looking for a higher position, you are expected to have probably a PhD in computer science or statistics or in a related field. But if you are looking for entry-level jobs in this field, so probably a bachelor's degree in some quantitative methods or data science or computer science or statistics might be very useful. If you go through skills that are needed, so some of the popular languages that companies use include R and Python, and technologies like cloud computing, structured query language, SQL, knowledge of statistical methods, and commonly used machine learning algorithms. And some of the libraries nowadays are very popular, like TensorFlow or Keras, H2O, and so on.